श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किक केसरी वेदांताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदाहृदि नमो नारायण। लेट्स एंजॉय वर्स नंबर 11 टुडे। वी शुड सी द श्लोकम विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड द प्रीवियस श्लोकम एंड Swami mentions in this verse so nicely, and he talks about how Perumal performs upakaram, takes avatarams, and by his taking avataram, how people still are unable to comprehend his avatara rahasyam, and they are deluded, think that he takes the human form, animal form. When he takes matsya avataram, kurma avataram, they are completely misled, and they think that they are in no way, he is in no way different from the forms that he takes, whereas he is not bound by karma. He is not like us taking the human birth or the animal birth or devata's birth. So the verse says, 11th verse, madhye virinchi shivayor vihitavataraha khyatosi tasamataya taditam nachitram maya vashena makaradi sharirinam tvam तानेव पश्यति करीषय देशलोकः। द श्लोकम फोकसेस ऑन कपल ऑफ आइटम्स। पेरुमाल्स सौलभ्य सौशील्यम, हिस् इन स्पाइट ऑफ हिस् स्वामित्वम, इन स्पाइट ऑफ हिस् सर्वेश्वरत्वम, ही स्टिल स्टूप्स डाउन सो लो, एक्सेसिबल टू ऑल ऑफ अस, takes the saulabhya saushilya avataram as a shaligrama, as the archavataram, or takes the vibhava avataram like Ramakrishna, Matsya, Kurma, Vara, Narasimha avataram, and the in spite of that, the pitiable state of chetanam, the jivatma, who is not able to understand his avatarams and not able to appreciate the supreme lordship's grace, saulabhya saushilyam, they are completely fooled by his taking that avataram, think that he is just one among us, and they belittle him, his saushilya saulabhyam. If a senior vice president is a friend to us, we do not recognize his position, his power, because of his simple, humble nature. He mixes with us and we think low of him and we do not respect him. We take him for granted. Our Lord has taken the avataram as Vishnu, in between Brahma and Shiva, as a Trinity. Those who are not knowledgeable think that he is equal to Brahma and Shiva, and he is not. He is the one who has given those two their positions, their powers. He is the proprietor, and they too are just the CFO and COO who are appointed by him, Sriman Narayana. He can simply fire them in 24 hours, 24 seconds. They do not recognize Perumal Sarveshwaratma. They misunderstand his avatar ragasyam, avatar karana. And the saulabhya saushilyam are misinterpreted by the unfortunate jivatmas. They think that the matsya avataram or kurma avataram, like he takes as a fish. He is only a human being. Is he an engineer who built that setu? People question. avajmudaha, foolish. And they think that he is equal to the other two, Brahma and Shivan, Trimurti. They have been given that position by you because of your saulapya sausilya. Further, you are the antaryami in them and you are the one who direct them, control them, and they themselves say that. In Mantra Raja Pata Stotram, the most eminent Rudra himself declares, Dasa Bhutaha Swatasarve Atmanaha Paramatmanaha Atohamapithe Dasaha Iti Matva Namamyaham. All Atmans are the servants of that Paramatman by their very nature. And I am your Dasam. Rudra says, knowing thus, I seek refuge with you. And those who are blessed with the Katakshama of Sriman Narayana at the time of their birth are said to gain this Sattva Gunam that leads them to become Mumukshu, to think of these lines. And the glances of others lead to rajas, tamas, that would lead them astray, and they become foolish to think that the Trimurtis are equal, or there is no God, or I am aham brahmasmi, all that. And it's declared clearly that gods like Brahma and Rudra are not upasyas for a person who desires moksham. Sriman Narayana is the upasya of even Brahma and Rudra, as well as all other mumukshus, those who are desirous of getting rid of this samsara sagaram. Samsar nava magnana vishaya kranta chetasam vishnupotam vina nanyat kinchitasti parayanam. For people whose minds are overpowered by the sense organs, who are drowned in the samsaric ocean, there is no other refuge other than the boat which is Vishnu. Here in this slokam, He Karisha, the Hastigiri Natha, Virincha Shivayo Madhye, between Shiva and Chaturmukha Brahma, you take the middle portion, Vigita Avataraha, as Vishnu. You take that form on your own accord, out of your saulabhyam. You could have simply instructed somebody else, appointed someone else for the protection role. But protection you wanted to take care of because of your dhayai, tvam, you. People think that tatsamataya. They think that you are equal to them. And taditam nachitram. This is not a surprise. Yat maya avashena makaradi sharinam tvam yesha lokaha taneva pashyati. This because you, when you take with your sankalpam matsya kurma varaha avataram, the world looks at you as the matsyam, as the kurmam, as varaham only. That's not a surprise. Even Parasara Bhattar mentions in Rangarajastavam, same. Madhye virincha kirisham prathamavataraha tatsamyataskayitum tavachet swarupam kimte paratva vishunairiha rangadhamanya sattva pravartana kripa paripalanadhyay. Your first avataram between Brahma and Rudra as Vishnu. Why did you do that, Lord Ranga? Parasara Bhattar is asking. He is saying, why did you have to do that? Why do you have to be equal to them? And you wanted to be simple saulabhyam, show your saulabhyam, sausilyam, and consider them equal to them. And if you want to mislead people, because ellirum veedu petral ulagillai endre, as the Leela Vibhuti, the world thinks that you are equal to them. And you gave us Vedam, Yogam, Upadesham and Karuna Karyam in order to increase Sattva Gunam in us. And everything declares your Paratvam, your Supreme Lordship. Everything says that you are Sarveshwaran, whereas they are your appointed bodies. Even then, you took the first avataram as Vishnu and the world is misled. What a horrible thing. Enna padakam. Look at the impact it has created on the world. You took the avataram as being equal to them, but you are the antaryami of them. You are the director. You are the controller. You are the seshi, master. The world is not able to understand. They think all three are equal. You are jagat karanam. You are the karana bhutan. You are the one who take them inside your stomach during the mahapralayam. You are parabrahman. You are not equal to them. You are superior to them. Sabrahma sasi vasrendra sokshara paramaswarat. You are the one who is Brahma, who is Rudran, who is Evendra. And as the antaryami, you are not sajatiyan as them, Brahma, Rudran. You, because of your sausilya saulabhyam, you became friendly to Guhan, Sugrivan, Vibhishanan. And you took the avataram as Bhuvarahan, Matsya Rupi, Drisimman. But you are a class different from all other forms. Avatara Rahasyam is required to be understood. Paratattvam, Pirappili, only Perumal. All others take birth. You have taken the birth. Raksharatam, Sarvabhutanam, Vishnutvam, Upajakmivan. In order to protect, you take these avatarams. You take the avataram as the younger brother of Devendra, Upendra. You took the avataram as equal to Brahma and Rudra, Taditam. So one needs to understand to the Trinity, namely Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra. People who are not knowledgeable treat him as an equal to Brahma. They do not recognize the Sarveshwaratma. The layman lack the clarity of perception and conclude that merely superficial equality, that all three are equal. No wonder this world look at the avatarams of Vishnu as Matsya, as Kurma, as huge boar, as no different from the actual species on earth. No wonder, not a surprise, Desika says. Even as they miss the anupravesham, the entry of the Supreme Lord in the fish incarnation, they very conscientiously ignore the Vishnu as the commanding authority of Brahma and Rudra as well. The Lord is a supreme, universal antaryami, the indweller. In every form, he is there. In every rupam, he is there. Matsya Kurmadikaram Tattvat Varaham Vapurasthitaha. Vishnu Puranam says, Veda Yajna Mayam Rupam Ashesha Jagatasthitav Sthitasthitiratma Sarvatma Pramadima Prajapatihi Janaloka Katai Siddhai Sanakadde Rabishputaha. Sanaka Siddha Veda Yajna Mayam Varaha Rupam Bhagavat Rupam They praise. And the world looks at him as mere Varaham and not Varaha Avataram. Alas, it's so unfortunate. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Adiye Namo Narayana. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarke Kesari Vedanta Charvariyome Sannidattam Sadahrdi Namo Narayana. Swami Desikan has been beautifully blessing us with several wonderful facets of Brahman through this Varadaraja's Panchasat. Here in the last sloka he mentioned about the Trinity the three are discharging their respective roles of creation, protection, and destruction. And just because of this setup, people are misled to think that Vishnu is on par with Brahma and Rudra. The layman lack the clarity in understanding. And it's not just laymen, even the educated ones, merely from the superficial parity of the three, just to mention that they are all equal. And the world in this manner looks at the avatars also as the mere human beings and not as the Lord himself. So he goes on this same and talks about sarira sariri bhavam in the 12th verse, which we will enjoy now. Brahmeti Shankara iti Indra iti Swaraditi Atmeti Sarvamiti Sarva Chara Chara Atman Hastisha Sarva Vachasam Avashana Simam Thvam Sarva Karana Mushanti Anapaya Vachaha Mushanti Anapaya Vachaha. He Hastisha, Hastigirinatha, He Sarva Chara Chara Atman, you are the Atma of all Chetana Achetanams, the souls, the Jivatmas and the matter. You have that as the Shariram, Anapaya Vachaha, the Nirdosha Vedas, the Vedas which are pure, have no defects, no mistakes, no follies. Nirdosha Vedam, Sarva Vachasam, for all padams, all words, all statements, anything that has a name, Avasana Sima, you are the ultimate. Varada, for anything that has a name, you are the innermost. Sarva Karanam, you are the Karana Bhutan. Tvam, such greatest you, about you, Brahmeti, Shankareti, Indareti, Swaratiti, Atmaiti, Sarvamiti, Ushanti. These words are referred to as Brahma, Shivan, Indiran, Swarat, Atma, Sarvam. They all refer to you because you are Sarvam, you are Karanabhutar. So anything, if somebody says Shivan, Indiran, Swarat, Atma, Sarvam, it refers to you, you and you alone. That's all the verse. Now let's enjoy the meaning. Here it talks about all words such as Brahman, Shivan, Indiran, Atma, Sarvam, all point to you ultimately as the Antaryami, Rupam, the indweller, the supreme being inside all of them. Because you are Karanan, you are Sarva Karanan, you are Karana Bhutan, you are the cause, and Yellai Nilam, you are the ultimate boundary. The Vedas proclaim you as the Sarva Antaryami of all Chetanas and Achetanam. The Vedas are Nirdosham. Vedas, as we saw last time, it's otherless, it's from time immemorial. And The Brahma Sutra also says Janmadyasya Yataha Atato Brahma Jignyasa. Then, therefore, an inquiry into Brahman is to be made. Then, therefore, after detailed study of Veda Vedangams, having realized the truth that karmas have little and non-permanent fruit, a person desires to make an inquiry into Brahman, as he will be longing to learn for a fruit which is infinite and permanent. And that is why the meaning of the term Brahman, Brahman denotes the highest person, Purushottaman, who is by nature opposed to all that is imperfection and who has got numerous infinite auspicious qualities. Akileheya Pratyanikan Ananta Kalyana Gunaganoga Maharnavan Ananta Kalyana Gunaika Rupan. The word Brahman means Brihatvam, greatness. The greatness is related to its nature and its quality. So the primary meaning of the word Brahman is meaning of the word jignasa, which is desire to know. So here is the Brahman means Brahatvam, greatness, and it is related to nature and quality. In nature he is great, in quality he is great. That's what is talked about here. Now we would enjoy the slokam after knowing what's Brahman. Here sarira sariri bhavam needs to be understood. Vedanta Desika describes this in Rahasya Trayasaram Pradhana Pratitantra Adhigaram, and he talks about sarira sariri bhavam as defined by Ramanuja in Sri Vashyam. Yasya chetanasya yat dravyam sarva atmana swarte dharayitum niyantum cha shakyam tachraisha swarupam cha tattasya shariram itaraha shariri. So this is described in this chapter. Swami mentions here that the body soul relationship between Paramatman and the other two entities. There are three entities. One is Chit, another is Achit, third is Ishwaran, Brahma, Brahman, Paramatman. So Jivatman is Chit, matter is Achit, and Brahman, Ishwaran, Paramatman. So the body-soul relationship establishes that all entities other than Brahman, itaraha, other than Brahman, are supported, ruled over, and used for his own exclusive purpose by Paramatman. So, adhara adeyam, supporter and supported, niyamaka niyamyam. So, that which is directed and director, seshi sesha, servant master. So, Lord Sriman Narayana is directly and immediately support of all substances other than himself, because he is Adhara. And to his essential qualities such as Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Anandatvam, Amalatvam, all these infinite auspicious attributes that are derived from Swarupa Nirupaka Dharma. Then how is he supporting the several attributes related to matter and Jivatma? The Paramatma is the Adharam for these, Jivatma and matter. So, just like our soul supports the body, supports the soul. Body is a sariram, soul is inside. Similarly, the entire Jivatma, group of Jivatmas and matter are like sariram for him who is a sariri. And how will this kind of relationship with Parabrahman benefit the Jivatma? From the realization of this, adhara adeyam, sesha sheshi, niyantru niyamyam, it will result in realization of him as the only one who is the Parama Purusharatham, attainment of Paramatma himself. So that's what we need to talk about. Here, one needs to understand that when it refers to Shivan, because he himself is a Jivatma, Brahman, Chaturmukha Brahma, another Jivatma, Indran, third Jivatma, Swatma, any Atma, Sarva, the matter, everything, Antar Bahishchatat Sarva Vyapya Narayana Sthita, Sarvam, all point to you ultimately as the Antaryami, the indweller, supreme being inside. So there is no unity between Jivatma and Paramatma anywhere, even in Sri Vaikuntha, even in Moksha. The liberated Jivatma does not become one with Brahman, because Brahman is ever pure. Jivatma is subjected to ignorance. How can the Brahman have avidya sometime and vidya later? Not possible. And Brahman alone is the Karana Bhuta. the supreme Brahman is in the causal state when it is qualified by chit and achit in the subtle fine form. When Brahman takes a will, sankalpam, to become many, bahusyam prajayeti, he makes the chit and achit assume the grass state like us. Even in this state, he remains to be the inmost self of all those entities. Tatshrishtva tadanu pravishya tadevanu pravishate, says Taittiriya Upanishad. Tatshrishtva, after creating, in creation, Achit undergoes transformation and assumes the various forms of the universe. Chit does not undergo this transformation just like matter, but there is an expansion and contraction of jnanam, consciousness, dharmabhuta jnanam, which happens to be the attribute of the chit. So the dharmi is the chit and the attribute is the dharmabhuta jnanam, which contracts and expands. All this happens according to the sankalpam of Ishvara, will of the Ishvara. Ishvara is qualified by the chit and achit in both these states, fine state as well as the gross state. So far, so good. Here, even Namalwar mentions that Udal Mishai Uirana Karandengum Parandulan. Sarira Sariri Bhavam is very beautifully established by Namalwar in that line, 1.1.7, Thiruvaimozhi. Swami Periyavachan Pillai gives a beautiful Vyakhyanam there. Ittal, first let's enjoy the Tamil, then we will try to have a crude translation of that line. Ittal, Shushtamana Padarthangalil, for this Udal Mishai Uirana Karandingum Parandulan, for that line, he says, the Vyakhyana Chakravarti, Ittal, Shushtamana Padarthangalil, Aradhyarana Devataigalode, Aradhyarana Devataigalode, Devatas are performed Aradhanam by us, the human beings, using the utensils and the upakaranams, the matter, as the objects for worshipping the devatas. So aradhyarana devataigalode, aradhakarana manushyarode, aradhana upakaranangalana tiryak stavarangalode, vashiyara sarva antaratmavai irikkirapadiyai sollugirade. Udal mishai uirana karandengum parandulan, he manifests everywhere as the soul and other itara vishayam as the body. He indwells everywhere as the sarva antaratma. Sarva charatman is the word in this verse, Varadaraja Panchasat. Here sarva charatman sarvam, this means sarva charatman means sukshma chitachit. Sharirak brahmam is the karana. Sarvam means stula chitachit. Sharirak brahmam as the karyam. Sarva charatman is karana. Sarvam means karyam, the effect. First is the cause, this is the effect. So that for the devatas who are the aradhyas, who are being worshipped, the manushyas who are the worshipper, who perform aradhanam for the devatas, the objects, the upakaranam, like the matter, the tiryak, stavaram, everything, vasiyara, with no difference, absolutely no difference, sarva antaratmavai irikkirapadi, Sriman Narayana manifests in all these things, in the devatas as the indweller, in the human beings as the worshipper, in the jivatmas, and in the matter, in the universe, itara vishayam. So Brahman, Shankaran, Indiran, Swarat, Atma, Sarvam, for any padam, any word, ultimately it means you and you alone. And Gajendran mentioned this when he called for the primordial chief. All devatas is chaham, naham, naham, nachaham. He is anallan, pennallan, aliyumallan. All words mean him. Purusha evetagum sarvam. and Veda Vakya Anapayam. Vedas are completely defectless. And you are also Anapayam. Satyam, Jnanam, Anandam, Anantam, Amalatvam. You are Agileheya Pratyanega, just like the Vedas. Such you are the one who gives Sakala Palams, because you are Varadan who grants Sakala Palams. When Brahman means Varadan, Varadan means Brahman. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Adiyen. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarke Kesari Vedanta Charivaryo Me Sannitattam Sadahardi. Namo Narayana. Swami Desikan, in Varadarajastamam that we are enjoying in this series to commemorate Atiri Varada's appearance once in 40 years. So we have enjoyed so far 12 verses of Varadaraja Panchasat. Today is the 13th verse. Swami mentioned in the last verse that Vedas refer to any word, any vak. The artham refers to you only. Any name refers to you only as the antaryami. And Vedas talk about that only. When Veda talks about whether Devata or any other itara vishayams, it all ultimately refers to you, Varada, Vedanta Desika mentioned. And here he goes on to explain that how does he give the fruits when people worship the demigods? How is it possible? The demigods like Brahma, Devendran, Rudran, Shivan, they give their respective benefits to their devotees. Swami responds here, Ekameva Advitiyam, only one that exists, and that is Sriman Narayana. Brahma, Shiva, the positions change. The Jivatmas at their exalted position take their roles as Brahma, Shiva, Devendra, like that Surya. So the verse goes like this. Ashadipeshu girisheshu chaturmukeshvapi avyahata vidinisheda mayi tavagnya hastisha nityamanupalana langanabhyam Pumsam Shubha Shubha Mayani Palani Sute. He Hastisha, the Hastigiri Isha, the Kanchi Varata, Ashadipeshu, Dikpalakas, the Dikpalakas, the people who are the gatekeepers in the various directions, the Devatas who protect the various 8 directions, Girisheshu, Rudrergal. Here he just watch the words, plural. Girisheshu, Rudrergal, the plural, Rudras, Shivans, means every kalpam, every cycle, they change. Chaturmukeshu, api, even Chaturmukha Brahmas. Avyahata, tadangagal illamal irupadu. Without any interruptions, always they are instructed, vidhi nishedamayi, do this, do not do this, do this, don't do this, like that, is instructed, they are instructed by you, and tava ajna, that your instructions, nityam, under all circumstances, at all times, respectively, anupalana being performed. Langanabhyam, if they transgress, means if they do not perform what is instructed by you. Shubha Ashubha Mayani, they will get Shukam or Dukkam respectively. Means they get Punya Papa Phalan because of performing or not performing. Performing Punyam, not performing Papam. The fruits are accrued by these performance or non-performance by in accordance with your instructions, even for those Chaturmukha Brahmas, Rudras, Dikpalakas, like that, O Varada. That's all. That's all he talks about in this verse. It's got a very, very subtle meanings. Varada, your Ajna, you say do this, you say don't do this, are the commands, instructions that you give through the Shastras. So that need to be performed, and these should be performed because you are the Lord. If one does, they get Punya, and if one does not do what you say, they get Papa. Whether it is to do or not to do, the instructions. They can be Ashtadikpalakas, they can be Rudras, they can be Chaturmukha Brahmas, they can be Devatas, they can be human beings, they can be anyone. Akritya Karanam, Kritya Varjanam. If you do that, Akritya Karanam, that which should not be done, if somebody does, you punish. If that should not be done, if somebody does, you punish. If something is to be done, but they don't do, you punish. Means, if Sandhya Trikala Sandhyavandanam is a must, is your Ajna. If somebody does not do, you declare that he is Mama Drohi. He is my Drohi. You yourself declare, Varada. So, you give the Palan, Punya Palan based on that. Here, there is a message for us, the Manushyas. Nityam Shastram, we need to perform as in accordance with Shastrams. Because Shruti Smritir Mamaivir Ajna, he says in another verdict. Shruti and Smriti are my Ajna, my instructions. And one needs to perform. Even in Brahma Sutra, it says Palamata Upapatte 3.2.37. Here, everything, our karmas, the upasanas, are for the pleasure of Perumal. He gets pleased with our compliance to his instructions. And because of that, he showers his daya on us to facilitate us to be in the path towards moksha. Other than Perumal, all of us are karmavashyas. All. Except him. All. Baddha jivatmas, mukta jivatmas. And if after attaining moksham, they are not karmavashya. Until they attain, they are. Whether it is Chaturmukha Brahma, whether he is Devendra or Rudra. In every kalpam, Brahma is new. Rudra also. That is why the plurals are Chaturmukheshvapi, even non-mukhas. So your Ajna keeps them under bond. And they attain their wonderful positions, exalted positions, like Chaturmukha Brahma and Sivan, because of millions of births, they have performed Aradhanam for Perumal, and they have attained Punya to reach this position. And even Mahabharatam Shanti Parvam says, Asya Devasya Mitusho Mahitvam, Rudran, he offered himself and all the havis in Sarvameda Yagam and then attained this Rudra Padavi. Mahabharatam Shanti Parvam says, and this Shanti Parvam says Brahma and Rudran and are instructed by Perumal to take the positions for Srishti and Samhara respectively. The Upanishad says Bhishasma Dvatah Pavate Bhisho Deti Suryaha Bhishasma Agnischendrascha Mrityurdhavati Panchamayiti. So here the sun, the Vayu, Indran, Agni, all these devatas perform their actions, duties with fear of obeying the instructions from Perumal. The Upanishad says Rudran Vyakyata in Srimad Bhagavatam, it says Rudran drank the poison because of the instruction from Perumal. Srimad Bhagavatam 8.7. Here Rudran got the boon that he would be the Pashupati in Taittiriya Samhita. All these are blessings from Perumal, but they are all karma vashya. They are bonded by karma. And whatever Brahma, Rudra undergo are applicable for even other devatas, that they are karma vashyas. And there are so many numerous pramanams, proofs, authoritative texts to establish this. And how can there be no difference between Devadirajan and other devatas? They say that the difference between a worm, an insect, and the Devendran, the difference is the same difference between Devendran and Devadirajan Perumal. So that's the scale of difference in terms of between devata, Idara Devata and Perumal. That's the difference. We should never ever think that they are almost there. No, the difference is the same. So he is Apara Karunanidhi. And if there is a need for moksham, we need to seek. If you do not have daya on your own atma and you seek, if you do not seek a desire for moksham, A.V. Gopalachar Swami says that he would be led to partiality of few human beings. That is why Shubha Ashubham. If you follow his instructions as per Shastra, you get Punyam. If you do not follow, you get Papam. That's all. It's only Punya Papam. Where is Moksha coming? Because if you keep in accordance, compliance with his Shastras, one fine morning he blesses you with the right mindset to seek him for a Sadacharyan and to get rid of the samsaric afflictions and to seek his grace and to surrender at his lotus feet, either through bhakti or prapatti, all that. So he expects you to feel pity on yourself, to have daya on your own atma and seek his grace to save him. Anbil Gopalachar Vyakyanam Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyan Gunashalini Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Namo Narayana Dasa.